السلام علیکم ورحمۃ اللہ. آج کا جو پروگرام ہے موجودہ رجحانات تعلیم کے میدان میں اس عنوان سے آج کا یہ پروگرام ترتیب دیا گیا ہے.
گڈ ایوننگ. وی ہیو اے اسمال پریزنٹیشن. وی ول لائک ٹو شو دس پریزنٹیشن ٹو یو. سو وی ول ٹرائی ٹو کیپ اٹ ایز شارٹ ایز پاسبل بیکاز وی ہیو اے اسپیشل گیسٹ ٹو ڈے. So you have been asked, you may ask, what is India Log Foundation? The India Log Foundation is for organization for education, peace and development. It was started by Turkish and Indian people, and this foundation and along with its sister organizations tries to open schools and other institutions. In the presentation we will try to show about this activities. So our presentation is Global Hizmet Educational Movement originated from Turkey. So there is a one global movement, educational movement, a movement which strives to open schools in all over world. And there is a one scholar who have inspired this movement. He is Fethullah Gulen. He is a Turkish scholar, thinker, author, poet, opinion leader, educational activist and preacher emeritus. He is regarded as an initiator and inspirer of the worldwide social movement of human values known as Hizmet, that is Hizmet, service movement. Despite the high regard millions hold for him, Gulen considers himself only one of the volunteers of the civil society movement he helped originate and denounces any attribution of leadership. So Fethullah Gulen, though he is initiator of this movement, so he accepts himself only as one of the volunteers. So this movement works in three areas: in illiteracy, poverty, and polarization. But in our today's topic, we are going to focus only on illiteracy. So Fethullah Gulen has been preaching many people in Turkey, and he was advising to establishment of schools, and he tells, a nation's durability depends on the education of the young generation, upon their being awakened to national spirit and consciousness and spiritually perfected. If nations cannot rise perfect generations to whom they can entrust their future is dark indeed. It was told by Fethullah Gulen, and through these messages he was inspiring people to establish schools. So by some estimates, over 1,000 educational institutions such as schools, tutorial centers and reading rooms have been established around the world in more than 135 countries. Today there are more than 1,000 schools in more than 135 countries. These schools are non-religious, non-denominational, secular schools sponsored by entrepreneurs, altruistic educators, and dedicated parents. It's a small movie presentation.
Motivated by his teaching, the volunteers have established hundreds of schools in over 80 countries, including Pakistan, Bangladesh, and India. Many students, inspired by Fethullah Gulen, have trained as teachers in order to be able to serve in these schools. Once graduated, they travel to different parts of the world, far from home, to educate future generations.
So he was motivating young generation to take teaching job. So he was advising his students to become teachers. And these teachers were going all over the world to establish schools, schools in Turkey and abroad. Regardless of their location, these schools are symbols of harmonious interfaith and intercultural relationships, successful unification of faith and reason, and dedication to service of humanity. So these schools also strive to give inspiration for children to also serve to their human citizen.
from different backgrounds, faiths and cultures. For example, in northern Iraq, 6 such schools have been running since 1999. In these schools, Sunni, Shia and Kurdish Iraqis study together the same syllabus in the same classrooms. In Zamboanga, on the southern Philippine island of Mindanao, there is another such school called the Philippine Turkish School of Tolerance. It was founded in 1995 in this very turbulent region, where the population is about half Muslim and half Christian. The school functions as an oasis of peace, with Christian and Muslim students learning side by side.
So these schools try to bring students from different backgrounds so that a peaceful world can be established. So besides the motivation of peace, the schools are also renowned for their academic excellence and universal values. Schools bestow universal values to students and praise it for academic excellence. Volunteers are also running schools in conflict-ridden regions, such as Philippines, Macedonia, Afghanistan, Northern Iraq, Bosnia and Kenya, and as well as developed countries. There are more than 200 schools in USA, and there are schools in UK and other developed countries as well. So these two girls are two students from a Turkish school in Iraqi city, wins golden medal in Bosnia. So these students have received gold medal for their project.
These schools are non-denominational and follow the national curriculum of the country in which they are based. They strive to combine academic excellence with the instruction of sound morals. Through the good example of teachers and other staff, these schools try to instill in students universal values, such as honesty, fairness, humility, respect for others, tolerance, responsibility, cooperativeness, and compassion.
Although it is fundamental that girls be brought up to be delicate like flowers and mild and affectionate educators of the children, due attention must be given to making them inflexible defenders of truth. So Fethullah Gulen tells that the mothers, the girls are the educators, they are the teachers of their children. So for that reason, the girls' education plays a very important role. He continues, otherwise we shall have transformed them into poor, impotent beings for the sake of delicacy and mildness. We must not forget that female lions are still lions. In that way, Fethullah Gulen has been giving a lot of importance for education of girl children. So, in this regard, there are many techniques which is developed by a movement to try to bring quality education so that students will be upbrought with good values. So one of the important aspects in movement is visit to students' home. So regularly teachers, they visit to students' home so that they meet the parents. They see where the students are studying. Do they have the separate study room? Are they having a table to study? So that the teacher will know, even if the student do not do the homework, so he will know what is the background of the student, what's the opportunity and what's the facilities that the student is having. That is through this, the teachers are better acquainted about students. And like that, there are many techniques which is followed by movement schools to give a better education. Another important aspect from teachers is to give a vision to students so that after graduation, the students will know what step they're going to take forward from that time onward. When the students are graduating from school, they will be knowing which department of the university they have to apply. So this vision enables students to opt for bigger goals, will opt them to achieve better, and this vision will also give them an ability to serve for citizens of their nation. Besides the schools, there are also universities. There are universities in USA, in Turkey, in Kyrgyzstan, Kazakhstan, Albania, Nigeria, Cambodia, Bosnia in Iraq, and Azerbaijan, and some more countries. A proper university is a university in Albania. Avoiding the physical sciences due to the fear that they will lead to heresy is childish. Seeing them as contrary to religion and faith, and as a means of rejecting religion, is prejudice and ignorance. So, Fethullah Gulen, being a theologian, at that time, before 90s, in the years of 70s and 60s and 50s, many religious leaders, they were afraid of science because they were thinking that the science and technology is something against religion. So, but Fethullah Gulen was telling that science is a kitabu kainat, so we have to learn the science as well. Science and technology are beneficial to the extent that they guarantee happiness and help us attain a true happiness, humanity. If they develop in a way that harms humanity, they become devils who block our road. So, a hand, and about whom you remain unconcerned. So he tells that as a human being, we have to try to reach all humans who has some kind of problems. It can be through education, through development, or through peace. Whenever I see a leaf falling from its branch in autumn, I feel as much pain as if my arms had been amputated. So he tells that when the leaf from the tree falls down, he feels that as if his arm is removed from his shoulder. So this pain that have inspired him to take initiative this global movement. So he also discussed about compassion. And the motto of this movement is living to let others to live. It's a core principle of Gulen's understanding of service. So he speaks that in our time we have a lot of problems, social should be based so that we enable people to live better life after us. So like that, he has been giving lectures for many years. So main motto of this movement is service for humanity. And some of our intellectuals and some of our scholars in today's meeting, they may be wondering that they have heard Fethullah Gulen's name first time. Actually, in 2008, when there was a poll conducted by Foreign Policy, so he was selected number one. He was selected number one among living public intellectuals. And a lot of recognitions are there. A lot of conferences have been organized in leading universities of the world to study the movement and Gulen's ideas. So the main motto is to bring students, children, next generation for peaceful and harmonious atmosphere. Thank you very much. Thank you for your attention.